Hey everybody, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. You know, when it comes to health, there's a lot of things you're supposed to do, but then there's a lot of things you're not supposed to do. And most of you are not going to like today's topic because most people consume daily the most abused drug on the planet, and that's caffeine. And yes, caffeine is a drug. So powerful that Coca Cola's original ingredient contained cocaine. And when they needed a replacement for it, the substitute was and still is caffeine. Now, whether it's in your morning coffee, you know, or tea, or the usual energy drinks, or sodas, or, you know, the pre-workout energy products, or dozens of other energy stimulatory products that contain caffeine. In fact, most people can't seem to start the day without getting their caffeine fix or hit. Now, the problem with caffeine is that it burns out your central nervous system and causes numerous negative changes in your hormones, which ultimately accelerates aging. And trust me when I tell you that the older you get, the worse these problems are. Now, the negative changes in your hormones is an increase in stress hormones such as cortisol. And this means more belly fat and also accelerated aging. A decrease in testosterone. This means less muscle and lower libido and sex drive. A decrease in growth hormone and IGF. This means more fat and accelerated aging. A decrease in thyroid hormones, slower metabolism and fat gain. A decrease in adrenal hormones, such as DHEA and pregnenolone and so forth. Also, a decrease in melatonin, which is the sleep and anti-aging hormone. Also, there's an increase in estrogen, which can lead to breast cancer, gynecomastia, which is man boobs and guys, also irregular menstruation cycles. Also, higher blood sugar and insulin insensitivity. This means more fat, less muscle, and potentially diabetes. Now, another major issue is neurological in that it causes issues by decreasing dopamine release and also dopamine receptor sensitivity. Both are bad because it decreases happiness and can cause Parkinson's. It also causes a decrease in another neurotransmitter, serotonin. This means, again, less happiness, more worry, stress, you know, anxiety and panic attacks. Now, there's other health problems that are non-hormonal. First of all, it causes oxidative stress and inflammation, related to numerous health problems, you know, aches and pains and so forth. Also, a pH imbalance, and that it causes more acidity in the body. This means more acid reflux, stomach problems, osteoporosis, also gut bacterial imbalances. Also, insomnia and poor sleep, and then you have shallow REM sleep, again, causing too many health problems and hormonal imbalances. It also causes high blood pressure and hypertension. Honestly, I can go on and on. And trust me when I tell you that when I take a little bit of caffeine, honestly, I feel amazing. I'm just happier, right? I'm very much more productive, and I just am more focused. But I've done this so many tests, right, with it that no matter what I do, within a few days, my body adapts. I need to slowly increase my dosages, and then my hormones start to change for the worse, as does my sleep, which is then turns into a negative cycle. And people who I've tested who habitually consume caffeine daily for years and years, like most people do, trust me, they have a lot of health issues because of it. However, not once will a doctor say, hey, get off the caffeine, it's killing you. This is because nobody even thinks of caffeine as a drug. And everyone does it, so they don't think about it. Remember, it's a very potent drug that works in many ways the same as cocaine. And both are natural and found in nature. But they're not supposed to be consumed in highly concentrated sources like we do in modern society. Anyway, like I said, I really like how caffeine feels. I just don't like dealing with the negatives, especially the hormonal imbalances, especially as I've gotten older. So what does this really mean? Because I know right now most people are thinking, listen, there's no way I'm going to stop my caffeine. I love my coffee and that's that. And yeah, I get it, honestly. However, the good news is that there are much safer, healthier, and even better solutions. Natural herbs, plant extracts, and amino acids that will give you all the energy and focus you need, but without any of the negative side effects that I've mentioned today. No crashes, no hormonal changes. Plus, they are actually good for your health, the body, and especially the mind. Better for memory, cognition, and mood. They actually help improve your hormones and neurotransmitters. They have anti-aging benefits, especially for your mind. Anyway, I've listed the ingredients in the formula below in the description area. And if you still want to have your, you know, caffeine products and coffee and all that, go ahead. But consider lowering the dose and using much healthier and healthier and better solutions that I've listed below. All right? This is all for your future. Well, that's it for today, guys. You know, I hope this video was more helpful and gave you some clarity. If you liked it, please subscribe. Also, please share the health with others if you think they can benefit as well. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.